Hello, I am Dr. D. Sarala at Department of Physics and Electronics. Today I would like to share with you my experience of using this Cisco WebEx video conferencing tool. So I thought, friends, I will share it with you. So before we start, we have to go to this site webex.co.in, and it will ask you, this is the world needs to connect, communicate and collaborate. This is the screen that you get it here. You can either host or you can join. Before that, you have to sign up. To sign up, you have to use your email, and all the instructions will be sent to your email. According to those instructions, you have to install that and get ready for your computer downloading this. Download that thing, and all the details are given in your mail. So you can either download it onto the PC, laptop or mobile phone or any one of these. Then this is how the window comes, and this is your meeting ID. You can either start a meeting or schedule the meeting. And if you have already scheduled, the upcoming meetings will be coming here. Then this is a URL. You have to copy and paste it and invite others to join you if you are hosting, if you are a host. You can send it by mails, or you can also send it, by means of WhatsApp. So when you send it by WhatsApp, this is how it will be coming. And then once you launch, these are all the things that you get. These are the sub menus. If you go to the account and click on this, your account name, your website, your email address will come. And if you go to a personal room, that is your classroom where you are inviting your students. So room link, room number, and then video address. And you have your own lock and key system. So this is has to be shared only with the trusted students, okay? Better not to share, because you already shared in your WhatsApp, that is enough. And then they can use their video device, laptop device, and then audio and all, phone, camera of the laptop can be used, apply all this. And then whatever meetings you are scheduling, they can, if it is a series of lectures that you are doing it, you can put them in the calendar. And if they use Outlook, most of us I think may not be using. If you use, it will be automatically updated on your Outlook calendar. Otherwise, since WebEx is already installed into their systems, a calendar will automatically get updated in this WebEx meeting calendar. Okay? And then suppose you are taking more than one class to different sections you are going, and then you want the students to be given some message, a notification. Depending on what you can set this time, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, they can be alerted to get ready for your classes. Also, it's like a timetable what you follow in your colleges. So you can just say from 1 hour each class. In between, if you give them a break, they take a break and come back to your class. So depending on how much break you are giving, so much time can be allotted here. Accordingly, they can be alerted. So they receive a message by means of different audios. You can choose, there are system inbuilt audios, or you can have your own way. Your own voice can be recorded and say, come back to the classes. We are going to start the class in a short while now. Something like that you can do. These are all the tools and facilities which are being provided. You make the best use of the same. And then when your participants are joining, that is your students, when they join, you can give them a beep sound. When they're leaving, you can or they can raise their hand, whichever way you want, you can do it. Okay, you can also have greetings like good morning, good afternoon, or whatever it is, that can be recorded and kept here. These are all the creative talents which a teacher can make use of. This is a thing. And then when you are inviting them by means of WhatsApp and other things, the participants list will be coming over here. As you can see, this is these are the two participants to start with, to experiment with. And this is their chat window. And whatever messages they are sending, they will be seen here. So you have your options here. First, initially, you have to mute them all, because all of them will be talking at the same time. The class looks, very noisy. And you will not be able to hear what they say. And at the same time, your lecture also will not be audible. First, mute them. And then you have your own video first. You can have their videos also, because you can see who are all listening cautiously and patiently and who are all paying attention, things like that. These are all the various buttons. We will go one by one. This is for sharing. This is start. The same button is a toggle. That means once you start, it will be starting. You press that again, it will be, you know, pause or stop. And this is a chart. These are the counters you can see. And this is the sharing option. So this we will explore later more now. So when you click on this chart, this messages will come. When you click on these three dots here, that is a sharing. So when you, this is sharing, this is sharing. This is how the screen comes. You can either share this entire screen or different parts of the screen. Whichever you want to do, you can share with your participants. So when you click on the share button here, you have these are the menus, text, slides, stickers, which are already been built. Whatever you can draw some circles while explaining, that also can be shared. Okay, you can cut from somewhere and paste it here, like if it's already prepared menu is there. And then you can have some screens, some images built in, or you can have a library of the images. They can also be shared. The science teachers, humanities teachers, if they want to make use of some locations, geographical locations, whatever they want to use, they can prepare those sheets, keep them here in the collection and share. You want to share some notes, some PowerPoint, some material, that also you can do it. So depend, it is when you say share a file, and it will look in, where do you want them to look into, the desktop, the D drive or whatever drive. You just create that, then you can. And you can also make use of some of these additional features, you know, adding some brushes, underlines, colors, if you draw something, all that. These are all, you know, that also can be done. This is something which is, you know, more than the basic features. So if you are interested in exploring, you can explore. And then these are the information that is needed that can be given before the meeting, which is optional. And then you can also identify the students who are doing good. And if you want those students to help you, you can make them as a host and you can share the notes with them and they will in turn share it. And they will explain it to their peers. You can see a peer mentoring. That also you can see by making use of this. One of the students, one of the participants as a host, and see how they are doing. So it's a kind of, you know, interactive sessions. So this is how you assign a host. And these are the basic features. And preset condition. There is something called preset. That is, before the meeting starts, you can have a welcome message displayed here. And you can tell your participants what you are planning to do. You can give a meeting heading. And you can say that you are sharing some presentations. You can chat with them. You can share some documents. Or you can copy paste in a URL here. That also. And then you can have your videos played by giving the URL. So these are the features. Another important feature is you can draw something. You can explain making use of these diagrams. So you can draw something, all this. So suppose I want to draw some XY axis. And then draw something like this, some points, all these you can do. But if you want this kind, this is known as annotation, writing on the screen. And if you want your participants also to make use of the screen and then they also write on this, that is possible, but it is better you don't. Because if everybody starts writing like this, your screen will be, you know, clumsy. You will not know what you've written and what they've written. That if they use the same color. So you can ask them to interact with you at a later stage once you finish your lecture. That looks more structured. So other than this, we also have privileges, you know, of these participants. What are the privileges that you are giving? When you are sharing a document, you can ask them, you know, to print. Okay, and then save the document, annotate, whatever. These are all the features that you are giving them. You can also allow all the participants to see themselves. You can check it or uncheck it. Accordingly, you can do it. You can make use of their video systems. And some, I told you, advanced students, you are asking them to help you and making them as a host. And they are doing peer mentoring or whatever. Some naughty students are there and you don't want them to continue in your class, so you can expel them. But when you are expelling, you have to go back to this the sharing option, disable the sharing, expel them, okay, and then come back. Otherwise, we don't want them to see that they are being removed. Okay. Also, you can conduct a quiz, test, or take a feedback. You can do it either before or after. So only a presenter will have these rights here. So you can say file, open poll questions. You can have short type, multiple type, multiple choice, objective type, single answer, short answer. It can't be definitely essay. So these are all the options. You can share with them. And when I'll come back to the media, multimedia sharing a little later. So you can ask them by raising these hands like this. Okay. And when they give a questions, you have written some questions here. What are the polling questions you are giving? Do you like the session? Do you recommend it to the others? Some such things. And they are giving their results. You can also click on a graph. If you have a, now I don't have so many participants to show you a graph. If you have, this is only a demo. So if you have a classroom of 50-100, depending on the questions and the answers they give, you can generate a graph here and see how many have polled for yes, how many have polled for no, and other things. So you can see a graphical analysis. Now, whatever I told you till now, or using a desktop application, you can also use a mobile phone. You can also see all these features on your phone. So you can create shortcuts, find devices. This is the polling that I just explained. You can chat with everyone. You can have only audio mode or video mode, whichever way you want, you can use it. So these are all the various features that are available. If you want to explore more, we will do it using a webinar.